Many have undertaken to set down an orderly account of the events that have been fulfilled among us, just as they were handed on to us by those who, from the beginning, were eyewitnesses and servants of the word. I too decided, after investigating everything carefully from the very first, to write an orderly account for you, most excellent Theophilus, so that you may know the truth concerning the things about which you have been instructed.
The Nativity story is set in Bethlehem, somewhere between 7 BC and 1 AD. It tells of the events of the birth of a special baby. Of all the people to have lived on earth, this baby has had the greatest impact of all people ever born. And the birth, over 2,000 years later, is to this day still celebrated worldwide as a special event called Christmas. The story begins in a town called Nazareth in Galilee. Mary, a young virgin girl, is betrothed to Joseph. As a devout believer in God, Mary prays regularly. During her prayers, an angel of the Lord appeared to her. This was to fulfill the prophecy in the book of Isaiah chapter 7 verse 14. The Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, because he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaid. For behold, henceforth all generations shall call me blessed, because he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is from generation to generation on those who fear him. He has shown might with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the conceit of their heart. He has put down the mighty from their thrones and has exalted the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty.
Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, and Joseph, her husband, being a righteous man and not wanting to disgrace her, planned to send her away secretly. But when he had considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child who has been conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Now all this took place to fulfill what was spoken by the Lord through the prophets. Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and he will be known as Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Joseph awoke from his sleep and did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took Mary as his wife.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. What a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Savior, I'm happy and blessed. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song.
Days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Bethlehem in Judea, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary.
How much profit should I make on tax reforms today? Should I leave a little bit or take it all away? How many people have I got? How many do we need? If we persecute a few, we could cut down the greed. I think I'll have a census. Yes, that's what I'll do. I'll table all of my people and call it the first who's who. I will have a census, collect and count the lot, see the classes of people, and total all the money they've got. I am the Emperor Caesar, my taxes will not please you. I just feel the need to increase my wealth. You will all give me information when you sign up for the nation, and I'm sure my bank balance will end up in good health. I will write this proclamation, calling all in the nation. Come reveal all in my book. Into your lives I'm going to look.
I will take this message to roll across the land. Everyone will read it.
left behind. Joseph goes on his way, soon it will be Christ's birthday. The light will shine for mankind. Joseph the man, traveling across open land. Bethlehem is the destiny, Mary is the mother to be. Joseph will help all he can.
Traveling with this heavy load, the sun is beating down. The heat is burning me, I face reality. My life will change in this town. Every task in life is a hard one. Something inside helps me carry on. Is this a mystery or intervening divinity, or just the way I should be? The donkey, Mary and me, fulfilling the prophecy, Christ will be born tonight. No matter what you do, this child will soon affect you. He's here to put the world right.
The long journey to Bethlehem was difficult for Joseph and Mary, a long, hot, dusty road, but a necessary journey to fulfill the prophecy of Micah, written around 700 years before the birth.
But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.
The stars. disappear.
Thank God we do believe. Thank God that this is Christmas Eve. Even as we kneel upon this day, even so the ancient legends say. Nearly 2,000 years ago, the stalled ox knelt, and even so the ass knelt full of praise, which they could not express while we can pray. Thank God, for Christ was born ages ago as on this morn. In the snow season undefiled, God came to earth a little child. He put his ancient glory by to live for us and then to die.
How shall we thank God? How shall we thank him and praise him worthily? What will he have who loved us thus? What present will he take from us? Will he take gold or precious heap of gems? Or shall we rather steep the air with incense or bring myrrh? What man will be our messenger to go to him and ask his will, which having learned we will fulfill, though he chose all we most prefer? What man will be our messenger?
The man is found, sure-footed, knowing well the ground. He knows the road, for this the way he travelled once, as on this day. He is our messenger beside. He is our door and path and guide. He also is our offering. He is the gift that we must bring. Let us kneel down with one accord and render thanks unto the Lord. For unto us a child is born upon this happy Christmas morn. For unto us a son is given, firstborn of God and heir of heaven.
At the time, King Herod was visited by three wise men from the east.
Caesar has got his way, the crowd has gathered here, waiting to sign the book, not knowing what is near. Over at Herod's place, three kings arrive, telling of a new king, how can a rock survive? In the stable at Bethlehem, Mary gave birth to Jesus Christ the Savior, God's Son. Got his way, the census names we bring. He may find it hard to register a king. Herod has his guess of things he'd like to know. Where to find a king he would like to go. In the state
down, the ladies asleep, they were prepared, then the bride.
closely the words I speak to you. I've gone far and far beyond. Here is what to do. Go to Bethlehem, a stable you will find. Take a small gift, show that you are kind.
We don't understand the message that you bring. Why is the sky so bright? And why do angels sing?
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem, Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and have come to worship him. When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, In Bethlehem of Judea.
Shepherds stayed a while, then went on their way. Then three kings arrived on the 12th day. They brought significant gifts, valuable as well. Gold, frankincense and myrrh, each with a story to tell.
And then the story he told. Gold represents a king, there's one in front of me.
Then he finished by praying quietly. Casper took his place, frankincense in hand. The symbol
full of praising and glory through the land. He laid down the gift before Christ the King.
The sign of worship, the sign of the ring.
Bows thus are offered very bitter perfume, the symbol of his death which points to the tomb.
We all live
when the kings packed up their things and they were ready to go, a dream the night before said, "Don't let Herod know. Go back another route. He is a nasty man. He will hunt the child and kill him if he can."
When the wise men had departed, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, "Arise, take the young child and his mother, flee to Egypt, and stay there until I bring you word. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him." When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night, and departed for Egypt, and was there until the death of Herod, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, "Out of Egypt I called my son."
Then Herod, when he saw that he was deceived by the wise men, was exceedingly angry. And he sent forth and put to death all the male children who were in Bethlehem and in all its districts, from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had determined from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what was spoken by Jeremiah the prophet, saying, "A voice was heard in Ramah, lamentation, weeping, and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children, refusing to be comforted because they are no more."
Thank you.
At that time there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And this man was righteous and devout, looking for the consolation of Israel. And the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Messiah.
The temple stood a man who was very old, Simeon, who by a prophet was told he would see the Christ before he died. Now the day had come, he would be satisfied. Simeon, the glory he could see. Mary was told by his prophecy. Many would live by this man, while others will crush him if they can. Who is this man,
the Savior?
Will he help us if he can? Is he the light of life? Who is this man? Jesus, you have your life ahead. Peace and love, but you will soon be dead. You will rebuild your church in 3 days. Your name will be treated in different ways. Life's a long, hard road. Your mind has a heavy load. No matter what you do, the Christ will soon affect you. Every task in life is a hard one. Something inside helps you carry on. Is it a mystery, or intervening divinity, or just the way we should be? Mystery. more intervening divinity. All the purpose of life we fail to see.
Thank you.